In my last video, I demonstrated to you how to use your knowledge of the roots of a fully factorised polynomial function to graph that function. I mentioned that there were three variations on the theme, and I was going to deal with them all in one video, but I realise that's going to take too long. So this is the first of three videos dealing with those three variations. And the theme for today's video is what happens if one of those factors, or more than one of those factors in the polynomial, appears to be reversed, particularly if there's a minus sign in front of the x value. And to do so, I want to first of all discuss a simple quadratic equation. That is, y equals x plus 2 times 4 minus x. We can see that the first term is exactly as we like it, with the x value first. But the second term is not. It has the x value last and it has a minus sign in front of it. Now, if you're used to finding roots, this is perfectly acceptable. But I want to show a particular principle to you, and for that we need to tidy up this factor. We leave the first factor untouched, but the second factor we have to factorise further, and we notice that there's a minus 1 coefficient in front of the x, and we remove that. Now normally we don't write the 1, but we remove that from this term. Minus 1 times x gives the minus x, and minus 1 times minus 4 gives us the plus 4. And you can see that removing the negative 1 or the minus 1 has had the effect of reversing the factor. Now, this term is multiplied by the minus 1, which is multiplied by this term. So we can, in fact, remove the minus 1 and place it out the front. Now, of course, we don't write the 1, but we do need the minus sign. And what we've successfully done in a couple of lines is we've rearranged the equation so that the term that appears to be reversed is now in the form we like, but a minus sign has appeared at the front. It's this minus sign that I want to talk about in terms of graphing. But first of all, let's find the roots of this equation. We set y equal to 0 to find the roots, and the roots must be, when this term is, when this factor is 0 at x equals negative 2, and when this factor is 0 when x is 4. You could have seen that back here and even here when 4 minus 4 makes 0. We now graph the quadratic equation. A root at negative 2, a root at plus 4, but what does this minus sign do? Well, when we expand this quadratic equation, the largest term is going to be the x squared term, and it is going to have a minus sign in front of it. There will be other terms, but as x gets very, very large, this term will dominate. And you can see that as x gets very, very large, x squared gets huge, and the minus in front makes it a huge negative number. In other words, the further we go towards large positive values of x, the larger a negative value y takes on. And therefore, the graph goes downwards at this end. As x increases, y decreases. Now, the rest of the graphing takes place as normal. That is, the graph has to come back through this root, and you can see that we have an upside down parabola because that minus sign has had the effect of making all the positive values negative and all the negative values positive for y. So what was in the negative part of the y-axis has now come up to the top, and what was in the positive part of the y-axis has now moved to the bottom. Let's have a look at a cubic equation and see how that same principle applies. So let's try a cubic equation. These two factors appear exactly as we would like them. This one appears in reverse. So we can take the minus sign out. I'm going to put it straight at the front. Leave that one untouched. This is going to become x minus 2. We can just check that. Minus x gives us the minus x, and minus minus 2 gives us the plus 2. To find the roots, we set y equal to 0, and our roots will be at 4, 2, and negative 3. When we graph the cubic equation, the roots are going to be at 4, 2, and negative 3. But remember, this minus sign means that the graph is going downwards when we go to the right instead of upwards. And that means the rest of the graph must go like this. Be aware with polynomials too, that the closer together the roots, the less distance the hump will rise. The further apart the roots, the greater the loop will be. Now, in the last video, we did graph a cubic equation and you saw that its basic shape was that. And this, in fact, is a complete vertical reversal of that graph. Now, if you were very fast, you would have noticed that this would also apply to straight lines. That is, polynomials where there is only one term. We could, of course, write this as minus x plus 4, but we could also take out a negative sign. So we have minus x, and minus minus 4 is plus 4. To find its root, we set y equal to 0, so the root is at 4. And when we come to graph the line, there's the root at 4. If you understand about finding y-intercepts when x is 0, you will understand the y-intercept is plus 4. But even if you didn't know that, you would know that the graph will head downwards to the right because of this minus sign. And in fact, that's exactly what it does. We call these negative gradients. And there's one other thing you may have noticed, and that is that you don't have to rearrange those factors anyway if you don't want to. The fact that I rearranged them was to draw your attention to that minus sign. So let's draw a very complicated polynomial. 2 minus x, x plus 4, x minus 3, 7 minus x, minus 2 minus x. This has 5 factors, so it's going to be an x to the power 5 polynomial. But we could simply find the roots immediately. I'm not going to be able to line my equal signs up, so I'll write the roots here. There's going to be a root when x is 2, because 2 minus 2 makes 0, at minus 4, at 3, at 7, and here x would have to be negative 2. So minus 2 minus minus 2 would make 0. And if you're happy reading the roots from factors like these, then there's no need to tidy it up too much. And if we wish to graph this polynomial, there's a root at 2, minus 4, at 3, at 7, I didn't leave room, and at minus 2. Now, how do I know whether the graph goes up or down at the end? Because I haven't bothered rearranging it. All I do is I look at the x terms as I multiply along. And I've got quite a few minus x's. I have minus times a plus times a plus times a minus times a minus. I have 3 minus x's. And when you multiply 3 negative numbers together, you get a negative. So if we rearranged all of this, we would have had a minus sign at the front and know that the graph would go downwards. And we've managed to do that without the rearranging. And of course, the rest of the graph would follow like so. So this is a very powerful graphing tool. And that is variation number 1. Watch out for your minus signs.